My journey leading up to podiatric medicine was quite a circuitous one. I mean, I was lucky enough to say my undergraduate university really made sure to emphasize the different choices that we had. They taught us what podiatry was, of course, if we went and sought that information. It was always there for me. I had friends towards the end of my undergraduate career who decided on podiatry. They were trying to convince me to start, but at that point, I was still very stubborn. I wanted to definitely do allopathic medicine, be an MD. That's all I knew. During the 3 years leading up to my decision to go into podiatry, I went and worked for a year. I took a few classes. I ended up doing a year of a post-bac program that was at an osteopathic medical school. Towards the end of that program, I started to reconsider my decisions. Okay, do I still want to apply to allopathic medical school? What is more related to what I'm looking for in my healthcare career? That led me to podiatry. I talked to those very same friends that were trying to convince me in the beginning, and we went through the process of my application after I went to shadow podiatrist. And that was quite an experience. My first time that I went, I saw something extreme for me. For a first time, I saw a leg pre-amputation in all of its glory, with the odor and all of that together, which is fine, but at the time, it was shocking to me to handle that. I was just down because I thought, okay, the one viable option I thought I had, I can't even handle it. I guess that's it for me. But I mustered up enough courage to return to the clinic, and sure enough, I fell in love with podiatry. The few things that I really like about podiatry that brought me here where I am today is the fact that you have a great work-life balance. You have that kind of time to spend all day working, of course, and then coming back home, being able to spend quality time with family, but still reap the benefits and rewards of treating patients. I like the fact that you have variety, because I always wanted to be a primary care physician due to the variety that I would get from seeing different patients every day, different family members. You see that in podiatry. Podiatry is, it's vast with the kind of cases that you see, with what you work with. But of course, there are going to be, like with any other specialty, days when you're doing the monotonous tasks like routine nail cutting. And despite that, it's still amazing because you truly get a lot of time with your patients. You really get to know them. And that rapport is also important to me. I mean, we got into this field, a lot of us, because we like that patient interaction. And so that's great. The other side is rarely, if ever, do you see dying patients or patients in critical conditions. And of course, who doesn't like that? Because you're treating patients. You're helping them. You're preventing what could be a critical case. And I think that's the most rewarding thing about podiatry. It's a growing field. We truly need patients who can specialize in that sense on the body region that we all take for granted. It's an incredibly essential part of our bodies. And as I had come to realize, a lot of things are related to it. And your lower extremities can say a lot about your health. If you have any other questions, feel free to ask.